Hey guys, my name is Jason with Mount Baker Mining and Metals, and on today's video, we're going to be smelting down some of these CPUs and trying to recover the gold out of them. So we've got our CPUs here, and I'm sure you guys know a lot more about these than I do, but there's a lot of gold in these. I think they're gold-plated pins. I think there's some gold bonding wires inside, and we're going to try and smelt them down and get the gold out. So I've got four that I'm going to use. I've weighed them, they weigh 105 grams. And the first step is we're gonna crush them down into smaller pieces so we can mix them in our crucible with some flux. And these are the four chips we're gonna be doing. And let me know which of these has the most gold in them. I think these two are the same. But anyway, there's the four we're gonna be doing. So our first step here is just gonna be crush them up, break them up. I'm just gonna hit them with a hammer. They don't have to be dust, but you know, we probably want them about quarter inch and smaller. So there you go. That's about as small as we need. And I don't know. I don't know all what's got gold on here, but we're gonna just melt it all down and see what we can recover. All right, here's all our chips crushed up. You can kind of see them close up here. There's that aluminum piece. I'm gonna throw that in there as well. But there's our chips. So now we'll mix up our flux, and it consists of three components. There's anhydrous borax, lye, and silica sand. And these are the same three components I use for smelting ore, and I'm just gonna apply them here to smelting these CPUs down. So I've got them mixed up. I used 100 grams of borax, 100 grams of lye, and then 50 grams of silica. I've added 30 grams of lead as a collector metal, and I'm just gonna put them in the furnace, melt everything down, and hope all the precious metals go to the bottom and we can collect them. Now we got everything in our crucible here. We'll get her on our furnace, heat her up, and melt it all down. Right after our pour, there was a bunch of ceramic chips left in the bottom of that crucible. So here I'm scraping them out, and we ended up with, I don't know, maybe 10, 20 grams of chips and some slag left over. So we'll get these all crushed up and see if we can get them panned out just with a gold pan and see if there's any precious metals or lead BBs or anything left in there that might be of value. Yeah, we had a little microphone malfunction here, but what I'm trying to tell you is when you pour the material into this cone mold, when it's molten, the very dense material goes down to the bottom of the cone, and all the slag floats on top. But all your precious metals and your lead collects down the bottom of the cone here, and then only the glass and the flux and the slag stay on top. So you have two parts. You have the slag on top and then the metal on the bottom. And a little tap of the hammer separates the metal from the slag. And we have our lead and precious metal button. So I'm taking our lead button and I'm just knocking the slag off. So here's our cleaned up button. And all the metals that we got molten are in this button. So the aluminum, the copper, the tin, the silver, gold, lead. And now we'll take it over to the CuePal furnace and we'll CuePal it and oxidize all those base metals away and be left with just the precious metals. All right, so here's our little CuePal furnace. And here's our magnesia CuePal. I'm gonna take our lead button and put it right in our magnesia CuePal. And that's gonna heat up to about 1775 degrees Fahrenheit. The lead will melt. The oxides that are formed also become molten at about 1650 degrees Fahrenheit. And once that happens, the oxides will start shedding off that molten lead button and be absorbed by the CuePal. And all the base metal oxides will end up being oxidized and we'll be left with our precious metal bead at the very bottom. So we'll check on our CuePal here. Here's our CuePal and the oxides are floating on top. It just came up to temperature. So it's not quite there yet, but we'll check back on it in 5 or 10 minutes and check and see how it's doing. But I keep the door cracked a little bit to let the oxygen circulate in there and we'll just let that reaction take place for a little while. We'll check on our CuePal here and yeah, our lead button's getting pretty small at this point. I found out actually there was a piece of steel that was in our lead, and so when the steel was floating there on top of our lead button, when the lead oxide was touching the steel and the iron in the piece of steel, the lead oxide was converting back to lead metal, and then it was oxidizing the iron, and then it had formed an iron coating of rust essentially over our button. So I had to pluck that piece of steel out, and now the reaction is continuing and the lead's almost gone. So we should have a button here before too long. So here's those little chips and stuff that we had, and we're gonna run it through this little Beco pulverizer, and the material feeds down here into these, between these two discs, and just this back disc goes around and the material grinds up till it can come out that little slot between the discs. And you can pull these off so you can kind of see the material feeds in here and this disc goes around and it just grinds up on these hardened discs until it can come out that little between the two plates. All right, so here's our ground up chips from the crucible. And I'm just gonna pan these a little bit here just to check and see if we have any precious metals, pins or little lead BBs or whatever that didn't come out with our lead collector metal. And so let me just get these panned down a little bit and we'll check and see what we got. I got a little cow magnet here, and on the back of one of those CPUs, there was a chunk of steel, and I just threw it in the pot, not really thinking, and it came back and bit us in the end, but there's a bunch of the little steel pieces and BBs and junk, probably ground up from the grinder as well. But I'm not seeing I'm not seeing anything exciting in the pan. Get a little pan down here again. So there's really nothing in there for gold. So I think all that shiny stuff is some of those little silicon chips, or what are those silicon? Those little chips in the middle. And you know, the rest is just little bits of ceramic and stuff. So hopefully all our gold's in our lead button in the CuePal furnace, and we'll see what we can recover. All right, I think our button's froze here. And we'll just take it, let it cool down some and see what color it is. So you can see some of that iron oxide junk around the edge of the CuePal. And so what I might do is I might wait till this cools, pull it out, and get a brand new CuePal, and then re-CuePal it just to make sure it's all nice and precious metal at that point. So there's our button. It's real silvery, actually, surprisingly. I was hoping for gold, but we may have enough base metals in there that I'm going to get it weighed and then re-CuePal it again with about another 20 grams of lead, just to see if we can pull out some more of those impurities and see if it really is silver in there or if we got gold in there that's just being hidden by base metals. And there's our bead. It weighs 1.07 grams. So I've got just about 20 grams of lead here. I'm going to put that in a fresh CuePal, put our little bead in there, and see if we can recover a gold-looking button instead of a silver-looking button. All right, here we're pulling her out for the second time. We'll let that cool down and see what color we got. And here's our button after the second CuePal. It's still silver in color and weighs 1.07 grams. So it's exactly the same weight that it was. So we'll take it over and get it XRF'd and see if we can figure out what's in this thing. So there you have it. According to the XRF, it's about two-thirds silver and about a third gold. So that was a real surprise to me. I was not expecting to have any silver. I was hoping for pretty much a pure gold bead. So what do you guys think? Where did all that silver come from? Were those pins silver with gold plating, or was there silver inside the CPU somewhere? So let me know what you think on that. The other thing that I would do differently next time is I would take off that little steel top piece that I thought was aluminum. I call it aluminum early in the video. But get that out of there. That's just junk that we don't want in our smelt, and it caused some problems for us. But I would also take our chips and I'd crush them up with a hammer, but then I'd grind them through that little Beco. I don't know what I was thinking. I was, slipped my mind. So if we can get them to a powder form, it might dissolve those ceramic chips a little bit better, so we can get a complete decomposition of the smelt and recover more metal. That being said, when I panned it out, I didn't see a whole lot of metal in there. It was mostly just the ceramic stuff. And so I don't think we lost a whole lot of precious metals, but it's always good to have a complete decomposition of your smelt. So those are the things I would do differently. But all that being said, we still recovered a little over 3/10 of a gram of gold. So it averages out to be about 1/10 of a gram per CPU of those four I did. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. Please let me know what you think and what I could do better next time or differently. And if you guys have any questions or comments, please leave them in the description below. So thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next video.